The most important thing is not completing the action, but to relax at the start. Then at contact, explode with power. Then move forward. That's enough. Am I not normal outside of the camera? Yeah. Yeah. I seem to be really abnormal in front of the camera. When you watch my highlights, I'm always off camera, right? So it shouldn't be surprising. During your rallies, the current shots don't spin as much, and they're not as irregular. The shots used to spin a lot. After the shot hit the table, it was irregular. It would just drop down. Unlike now, it drops like a rainbow. It's all like this. In the past, the heavily spun shot would drop and go straight down, and it had more power. The shot felt like it was pressing against the player. Yeah, it felt like, why couldn't I rally against him? I couldn't out-rally him because, in the beginning, if I couldn't hit a straight line and hit to this spot, actually, while moving, it's hard to exert power. You must change the direction first. We both tried to rally. And one more thing, when I'm looping now, your movements also. Before switching to the larger ball, you had already fixed your movements. In the past, I also loop spin shots. I wanted to loop those shots with more curve. The rubber had stronger spin. When I exerted 100% power, it would still be 100 or even 120 after it passed over. But now, when you try to spin the ball, it doesn't stay on the paddle as long. Yeah, and once it hits the table, it goes from 100 spin to 70, and then when you loop, the spin stops at that spot. So at this point, you need to remember, last time during the live stream, I mentioned to raise your hand, yes, from low to high. This movement creates the curve. Yeah, I notice sometimes people ask, how to loop? Should I do this? Back swinging the hand this way is normal, right? For underspin shots, it might be lower. Now that the spin isn't as strong, you can actually raise your hand a bit higher. Raising your hand definitely increases impact. If you put more power into the shot now, the impact will definitely be greater. When Aruna rallies, his arm swings like this. It's like he's hitting with his hand above his head. It's a bit like riding a horse. Like cracking a whip, his shots have high quality, so you can try this. Raising your hand. When your hand is lower, your paddle is more vertical. It can't be like this, because you need to create a higher arc. But if you raise your hand, your paddle face can be more horizontal, like sweeping horizontally. Now you need quality. This way you can maintain more consistent power. When I serve, you directly loop. Look at your movement now. Yeah, that's it. You need to raise your hand and hit horizontally. There wasn't much power just now. This isn't quite right. You can hear from the paddle sound, more friction and less impact makes this sound. Yeah, this sound means more impact and less friction. The difference is significant. I'm just exaggerating it a bit. You might have done it like this before too. This is different. Raising your hand higher and keeping the paddle more horizontal, especially in rallies, coming from below won't work. Like this? My intuition is pretty good. You can press down more. The higher you raise your hand, the more horizontal the paddle. When hitting high shots, you can't do this. It needs to be nearly horizontal. This feels right. You don't need to retract your forearm as much. When you make contact with the shot, you need to add power suddenly. After adding power, you don't need to retract your arm back. Because I think the textbook way of teaching shots is like this. Doing this move this way. Doing it like this is complete. But when you really exert power, after making contact with the shot, you can move your hand straight forward. Yes, you can move your hand forward. That shot was not good. Your legs weren't in position. That was good. You need to move your legs. All your hitting points should be in this position. When you hit, make sure to always hit from this spot. You see, sometimes in matches, we don't have time. Sometimes the shot comes here. I might just squeeze it like this. The quality won't be high. But when you have the chance, you need to fix this position. Control every shot from this spot. So if the shot is here, I might need to move my feet this way. The quality of the shot will be high. So legs are important. More power. Find the right spot. What is this? I served a long shot. Yes, you still stayed there. When I serve long, yes, you need to move. When I serve short shots, but you retracted your forearm. Keep moving forward. After contacting the shot, move straight forward. Before, when we counter-looped, we had a name for a good counter-loop. The immortal points the way. Regardless of whether the shot lands, sometimes it's the same even if it's lower. When you loop straight shots, you can't hold back. You have 2 points straight out. For example, you loop a slow loop. I counter loop. I counter loop to here. Maybe like this. I would hold back like this, right? If I loop straight, I would do it like this. Okay, another one. Forward like this. The most important thing is not completing the action, but to relax at the start. Then at contact, explode with power. Then move forward. That's enough. All the other things are just flashy, not important. The hitting movement is the most important. Okay. Now it feels better. I feel my shots are noticeably longer. Yes, exactly. Reaching the end of the table more.